Hello everyone, today I will be discussing an important topic, that is diuretics. Before going in detail about diuretics, let us discuss about parts of nephron and what are the enzymes present and what is the mechanism of reabsorption of water and electrolytes. So this is the structure of nephron. This is the glomerulus and Bowman's capsule. This is the proximal convoluted tubule, that is PCT. This is the loop of Henle and this is the DCT and this is the collecting duct. So coming to this PCT, in this PCT there is enzyme called as carbonic anhydrase and there is reabsorption of sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride. In this PCT there is reabsorption of sodium bicarbonate and sodium chloride. In PCT, that is proximal convoluted tubule, whereas in this loop of Henle there is only absorption of water, there is no salt absorption, so urine gets concentrated. So this segment is called as concentrating segment of nephron. This Henle's loop, there is only absorption of water, whereas this is the descending limb, whereas this is the ascending limb of loop of Henle. In this ascending limb of loop of Henle there is sodium potassium 2 chloride symporter. In this, most of the salts are reabsorbed. So this is called as diluting segment. This descending segment is concentrating segment. Whereas this ascending segment is called as diluting segment of the loop of Henle, because most of the salts are reabsorbed here. In this ascending loop of Henle, there is sodium potassium 2 chloride symporter. So all the salts are reabsorbed. That's why this is called as diluting segment of the loop of Henle. Coming to distal convoluted tubule. In this, there is sodium chloride symporter. So 10% of the sodium chloride is absorbed. There is calcium absorption also. In this DCT, there is absorption of calcium also because of the hormone called as parathormone. And 5% of the unabsorbed NaCl goes into collecting ducts. These are the collecting ducts. In this collecting duct, there is hormone called as ADH and aldosterone. So this is about the structural and functional unit of the kidney, that is nephron and parts of nephron, and what are the molecules get absorbed in the different parts of the nephron. So let us study about the diuretics. What are diuretics? What is the classification of diuretics? And what are the examples? And what is the mechanism of action? And what are the side effects of the drugs? So the first one is carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. What are the examples for these carbonic anhydrase inhibitors? Acetazolamide, dorzolamide, and brinzolamide. So these are the carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. What is the site of action? This carbonic anhydrase is present in PCT. So site of action is PCT. These are the non-competitive and reversible inhibitors. Non-competitive and reversible inhibitors of the carbonic anhydrase. As it blocks the carbonic anhydrase, sodium bicarbonate is not absorbed. So it is lost in urine. Because this bicarbonate is lost, there is increase in acidic content. So it causes metabolic acidosis. And it also inhibits sodium chloride absorption. So increase sodium load in the collecting duct. Because this carbonic anhydrase also acts on the collecting duct, when we give carbonic anhydrase inhibitors, it inhibits the secretion of H+. So it causes acidosis, but it doesn't affect the potassium excretion. So it causes the hypokalemia. So this carbonic anhydrase inhibitors causes metabolic acidosis and hypokalemia. What are the side effects of this carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. As it is sulfur drug derivative, it can cause allergy and bone marrow suppression. These are the side effects of this carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. What are the contraindication for these drugs? We should not give in metabolic acidosis in liver failure patients, and if patient is having severe chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, in this patient we should not give carbonic anhydrase inhibitors. Next one is loop diuretics. As name suggests, it acts on the loop of Henle. What are the drugs? We have furosemide, which is the most commonly used drug, bumotanide, torsemide, ethacrynic acid, this torsemide is the longest acting, whereas bumotanide is the most potent drug. The site of action is thick ascending limb of loop of Henle. What is the mechanism of action? It inhibits the sodium potassium 2 chloride symporter. Which is present in the loop of Henle. By this, there is loss of sodium, potassium, chloride. Along with this, there is loss of magnesium and calcium. Because there is loss of sodium and chloride, as sodium and chloride are not absorbed in collecting ducts, there is more of H plus and potassium secretion. Which causes the metabolic alkalosis. So this loop diuretics causes metabolic alkalosis. One of the important drug is furosemide, which is the example for loop diuretic. Furosemide, most commonly we use. So this is a vasodilator. It increases the intrarenal blood supply. So it is used in renal failure, and we can give in left ventricular failure patients. In left ventricular failure, furosemide only relieves symptoms. It does not modify the disease. And furosemide is the most commonly used drug for the rapid symptom relief in case of acute left ventricular failure. So these are the uses of furosemide. What are the side effects of furosemide? Most common side effects are dehydration, hypotension, and there is electrolyte loss. And there are metabolic problems like there is hyperuricemia, hyperglycemia, hyperlipidemia, and metabolic alkalosis. These are the metabolic problems of the furosemide. This is the one of the important question. It causes hyperuricemia, hyperglycemia, hyperlipidemia, and metabolic alkalosis. Rarely it can cause ototoxicity. Highest ototoxic drug is ethacrynic acid. Next one is thiazide diuretics. What are the drugs in this class? There is indapamide, chlorothiazide, and metolazone. These are the drugs in thiazide diuretics. What is the site of action? Site of action is distal convoluted tubule. What is the mechanism of action? Diuretics inhibits the sodium chloride symporter. So there is loss of sodium and chloride. So there is increased load of sodium and chloride in the collecting duct. In this, these drugs causes hypokalemia and metabolic alkalosis. Thiazides promotes the reabsorption of the calcium, so it causes hypercalcemia. Loop diuretics and thiazides have opposite action on the calcium absorption. Thiazides retains the calcium, whereas loop diuretics loses the calcium in urine, which causes the hypercalciuria, which can lead to kidney stones. So thiazides are the good choice. What are the uses of thiazides? It has diuretic property, so it is used in mild to moderate edema, and it is the first line for the mild to moderate hypertension, whereas it has also antidiuretic property. So it is used in nephrogenic diabetes insipidus, as it decreases the calcium excretion in urine. So it is safe in nephrolithiasis patients. So it is used in idiopathic hypercalciuria. So this thiazide diuretics have diuretic property and antidiuretic property. Because of diuretic property, it is the first line for the mild to moderate hypertension. Because of antidiuretic property, it is used in idiopathic hypercalciuria. What are the side effects of the thiazide diuretics? There is water loss, so it can cause dehydration, hypotension, and there is electrolyte loss also. What are the metabolic problems in thiazide diuretics? Metabolic problems are, there is hyperglycemia, there is hyperuricemia, there is hyperlipidemia, and it also causes metabolic alkalosis. These are the metabolic problems associated with thiazide diuretics uses. Rarely it can cause erectile dysfunction. Next one is potassium sparing diuretics. In this, again, there are two types. That is aldosterone antagonist and epithelial sodium channel blocker. Epithelial sodium channel blocker. What are the examples for aldosterone antagonist? We have spironolactone, Canrinone, Eplirenone, Drospirenone. What are the epithelial sodium channel blockers? We have amiloride and triamterene. First, we will study about the spironolactone. Spironolactone, this is the example for aldosterone antagonist. What is the site of action? Site of action is collecting duct. It acts on collecting duct. What is the mechanism? It causes aldosterone inhibition. It acts from the interstitium. It doesn't act from the lumen side, it acts from the interstitium side of the collecting duct. As it blocks the aldosterone, there is no reabsorption of sodium and water, and also there is no secretion of potassium and H+. That's why it causes hyperkalemia and it causes metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis. So it can be used in primary hyperaldosteronism and it can be used in secondary hyperaldosteronism. What are the adverse effects of this spironolactone? It can cause hyperkalemia, metabolic acidosis. As it has anti-androgenic action, it can also cause gynecomastia. Next one is amiloride. Amiloride is the example for epithelial sodium channel blocker. It is also potassium sparing. It acts from the luminal side of the collecting duct. Luminal side of collecting duct. What are the uses of amyloid? We can use in Liddle syndrome. That is, in this Liddle syndrome, there is congenital overactive epithelial channels. So, as it blocks the sodium epithelial channels, it is used in Liddle syndrome. Amyloid can be used in lithium-induced diabetes insipidus. And it can be used in cystic fibrosis. What are the uses of amyloid? We can use in Liddle syndrome and lithium-induced diabetes insipidus. And it can be used in cystic fibrosis. Next one is osmotic diuretic. What is the example for osmotic diuretic? We have mannitol. So what is the site of action? Mannitol acts on loop of Henle and also it acts on proximal convoluted tubule. What are the indications? Mannitol can be used in glaucoma and cerebral edema and cisplatin toxicity. What are the uses of mannitol? It can be used in glaucoma and cerebral edema and cisplatin toxicity. What are the contraindications for mannitol? It should not be used in pulmonary edema and cerebral hemorrhage. In these patients, we should not give mannitol. What are the side effects of mannitol? It can cause headache, hyponatremia. So in this session, we have discussed about structural and functional unit of kidney, that is nephron, and what are the parts of nephron, and what are the supporters present in the nephron. And we have studied about the diuretics. What are the different types of diuretics? What is the classification of diuretics? What are the different types of drugs? And what is the mechanism of action of individual drug? And what are the uses of drugs? So if you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. And subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.